Everything went down in Canberra like yesterday afternoon, early evening. It just went on and on and on. And very, very emotional. We've got on the phone the unruly Julia Spillard. Good morning, Julia.
Good morning, and I am hung over.
Are you really?
Yes.
What was the first thing you said to the Governor-General? Did you two have a little bit of a drink, or what went down there?
Well, I said to the Governor-General, I said, poor me, another brandy. No, 10's not too many, just pour it.
Now, Jewel, you did advise us last night you would not be recontesting your seat. So which new career do you have in mind?
Well, it's well known that I will be leaving Labor and taking up a labour of love. You might remember last night in my amazingly dignified speech that my niece is giving birth in July. Mm. And so I'm looking forward to becoming a meddlesome aunt, but I will not stop there. I will create a great Aunty Army that will continue to take over the world, help children, society, the most vulnerable, labour of love. And I'm still drunk from last night, by the way.
Well, you're less official now, so I hope you don't mind me calling you Jules. Jules, have you spoken to Kevin Rudd this morning, and do you know where he is?
Yes, I said, you can have it, and you can have it. And then where he is, I don't know, probably stepping over the empties at the Governor-General's that I left out on the lawn when I passed out there.
Bill Shorten, what do you think of him, Jules?
I've deleted him from my Facebook.
And Anthony Albenese, I mean, I thought he was in your camp too. I mean, you really gave him a big, wind-up in March, but you said, oh, no, fantastic. What happened there?
Kevin O'Leven and Albenese Lemon Squeezy, that's all I have to say about that.
Look, Jules, I know it was an eventful night, but did you get any chance at all to take a look at Origin 2 or Wimbledon? So much good sport last night.
Oh, look, I was just hoping it'd be all over so I could sit down and watch the game and watch Queensland get thumped, but that didn't happen. They won by 57 to 45. Oh, no, they're my scores.
Yes. Aside from the free grog, what are you going to miss most about the life in the lodge, Jules?
Oh, look, I'm happy wherever I am as long as I've got my knitting needles nearby. I'm just sad that Tim didn't get to finish the holding up on bricks in the lounge room lodge.
Speaking of Tim, I mean, how is he? Has he sort of got his head around that he could be the main breadwinner now? I mean, what's he going to do?
Oh, well, I didn't come home last night, did I? So he's gone off with Bob Brown on a cruise on the Blue Shepherd.
The unreal Julia Spillard.
You know what I'm sad about? What? We're not going to get to talk anymore.
Oh, JG.
I think we'll find excuses.
We will catch up, I promise.
Okay. All right.
Have one for
us. I'm going to go. I don't feel well.
All right. See you, Jules.
Bye, Jules.
Oh,
the unreal Julia Spillard, otherwise known as Gabby Millgate. You can check out her website at gabbymillgate.com.au.
We are going to have to come up with an excuse.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we'll find a reason.
Traffic and news on the way very, very soon. Bernard Fanning after 7:30, and Carmen's going to be having her entertainment rundown too. That and more on Perth 96.